Good morning to you all from Brussels. Let me start by congratulating the Portuguese presidency for getting this topic into its agenda and with such relevance. Also, thanks for the invitation to participate in this event, and congratulations to ANACOM and special to José Barros for the organization. Thanks also to Philippe Batista for all the work we have done together here in Brussels about connectivity. We live in the age of connectivity. People, things and data travel the world at unprecedented pace. However, as people and things need highways, airports, planes, trains and trucks, so those data need its own version of infrastructure. Despite words like wireless or cloud, there is no digital economy without a robust physical infrastructure. This is clearly one of the overlooked dimensions of the digital transition. In fact, in the EU, we have one of the best legal frameworks and a solid digital infrastructure for internal connectivity that nevertheless must be improved both networks and storage infrastructure. However, we must be prepared for the future and for the exponential growth of international data flows of the coming years. Massive amounts of data will travel in and out of Europe. So, international connectivity is as important as internal connectivity for the digital world without borders. The message is clear. Europe cannot become an island in the digital ocean. The expansion of Europe's international connectivity serves not only to achieve digital sovereignty and to make autonomous technological choice, but also to strengthen its strategic international links to other digital markets. The Portuguese presidency has worked to showcase here Elalink. Elalink is a fiber optic submarine cable offering secure high capacity and low latency connectivity between Latin America, Fortaleza, Brazil, and Europe, Sines, Portugal. Now, let me tell you something. International connectivity is not just connectivity by itself, but a first step in a path filled with opportunities for engagement. Around the globe, governments and companies are trying to adapt to new realities and to harvest the huge potential brought by emerging technologies and data. This is most often based on distinct principles, values, and cultures, of course. With the digital transition happening at a global scale and with a deep interconnection between all actors, no single nation or political body can shape it alone. There are some countries which understood this a while ago and are already trying to influence the discussion. Both the US and China have their views of a digital society, two different frameworks. And despite recent rapprochement of the US, their framework is still distinct enough to justify a need to pursue our own path. If the EU wants to be able to choose its digital way of life, it must strengthen its voice and search for allies across the world. These allies must be aligned with European values and principles for a digital transition, upholding fundamental rights, protecting consumers, and contributing to a sustainable development. We can look at GDPR as a use case of so-called Brussels effect. The adoption of GDPR has spurred other countries in many regions of the world. This is a truly global trend that includes Chile, Brazil, Kenya, India, Indonesia, Japan, South Korea, or even California. It's a clear example of the ability of EU to be a global standard setter for the regulation of the digital economy. Moreover, this kind of alliance should not be limited to the governments and parliaments. We need to adopt a multi-stakeholder approach, including the public and private sector, academia, and non-governmental organizations, as well as include citizens' perspective as a key to legitimize digital policies and promote bridges between civil societies worldwide. Connectivity is a crucial step in this path, and the Ellalink is again a perfect example. This submarine cable will bring two of the largest data markets together and create economic opportunities for Europeans and Latin Americans alike. 11 European and Latin American research and education networks from Brazil, Chile, Colombia, Ecuador, France, Germany, Italy, Portugal, and Spain, together with regional networks Red Clara, the Latin American Research and Education Network, and GENT, the Pan-European Research and Education Network, have already formed a consortium that is attached to this cable, the BELA Consortium. There are European funds from different programs to support this initiative. And I believe we have to go forward with the new partnerships in different areas involving private and public actors. This is also an opportunity to align some of our core principles for the digital transition in topics such as data privacy, competition, regulation of intermediaries, or artificial intelligence, of course. We are discussing here in the European Parliament a lot of proposals to regulate digital single markets, such as Digital Service Act for content, Digital Market Act for better competition, Data Governance Act for the reuse and sharing of data in order to build an European data space, and also referring the altruism of data, and the AI Act to improve trust in the AI applications. Starting discussing with our allies in the world countries that have the same concerns as you, the principles of this regulation is a priority if EU wants to contribute decisively to establish a democratic standard for digital markets. I have said that international connectivity is a future and allows the EU to become a world-class data hub, and we need to be. Here I also have an example for you, SINES 4.0. It is a 3.5 billion euros project to build a hyperscaler data center that will place Portugal and Europe at the center of the international data and connectivity market. The project is completely aligned with essential items of the agenda of the European Commission and the Portuguese presidency of the European Council, combining two important purposes. On the one hand, the contribution to the consolidation of the energy transition. And on the other hand, the contribution to the digital transition by locating in Portugal a world-class state-of-the-art data center. And SINES 4.0 is also a great reminder of why internal connectivity must not be forgotten too. This is not just a Portuguese, but European project that requires excellent internal connectivity in the EU, so that data originating in or entering in the EU through any point can easily reach any other place inside it. We need the creation of a strong resilience and redundancy to internal digital networks that are being deployed, HGPC, 5G corridors, and data storage infrastructure. And last but not least, cybersecurity. We need to quickly invest in our collective cybersecurity to ensure the EU is safe for business and safe for citizens. And also to invest in cybersecurity of submarine cables, of course. I'm very happy to be here with you to kick off 2 days of intense discussion around all of these topics, and I'm sure much more. I wish everyone a good conference, and I hope to see you here in Brussels, in the Parliament, in the future, and to keep this discussion going. Thanks a lot.